Welcome to Pop-Up Camper Pro. I'm your host, Eric Smith, and today I'm going to teach you everything you need to know about replacing the lift trim on your Coleman or Fleetwood pop-up camper. All right, what is a lift trim? What the lift trim is a cover that does two functions. It keeps dirt and debris out of the channel where the lift arms go through the body, and it stabilizes these arms. So there's four on your camper, and they're installed to the top deck around every lift arm on Coleman and Fleetwood pop-ups. Now, these trims can develop small cracks or even break in windy conditions when the roof is moving around too much, or even just over time with the 20 years of use. So I've just had a bunch of new ones made. I've got two different styles that best covers all the different types that they made over many, many years. Here's the basic tools that we're going to be using to install, and let me show you how to do it. The camper that we're working on today is one I'm disassembling. Here in Maryland, it's January, and we experienced another large snow event, and it is way too cold and way too snowy to get something complete into the shop to show you how to do this. So don't pay attention to the barely there pop-up camper. The area that we need to work on is still intact. Step one is removing the old trim. So it's fastened on by two rivets. I've got a drill and a drill bit slightly larger than the inside hole on the rivet. Drill both of these rivets out. And we see we have some gasket material left here on the camper. If it's in good shape, you can leave it there. If it's not, I actually got some gasket material and just used the new trims as a template to cut that. We'll go ahead and remove in this instance, but you could also just sections of putty tape. And this is even if you want to. I don't think it's 100% necessary. These are weather guards. It doesn't matter if water gets in here. One of the beauties of Coleman and pop-up campers is if water gets in this area, it runs right out underneath the camper. We'll use a 5-in-1 to remove this old material since we already have brand new options. If it's really stubborn, just heat it up a little bit with a heat gun. These came off just fine. I mentioned at the start of the video, we have two new styles of lift trim, and here they are. This is almost an exact mirror to the one that came off of this 1980s unit. This is another style that would work on this camper as well. These two will fit the majority of Coleman and Fleetwood pop-ups. For this one, we'll go ahead and put this gasket down that I cut. And for this style, you will commonly find the little buttons that you saw fly off when I blew the metal shavings off from drilling the rivets. I'll put links to these in the description below, as well as the lift trims. But these little buttons, you don't really need them for this style. All right, so we just position it over where it needs to sit. I have two rivets. Wider, broader heads on top. Feed those into the hole. To install, I'll be using an air power rivet gun, and I have my air compressor set to about 90 PSI. Let's install the second style. Drill these rivets. For this one, let's just use a little bit of butyl tape. So just rip some squares. I'm just gonna place it right here where the rivets are gonna go through. Remember with this one, we don't need the small buttons, plastic buttons. Push your rivets through and install. And there you go. It's another do-it-yourself job that you can do. Thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe to the channel, ring the notification bell, and mash that notification. Did I say that right? No, I didn't say that right. Ring the notification bell and give the video a thumbs up if you thought it was helpful. I'll see you guys at the campground with new lift trims on your camper.